After an eternity, after millions of years, Adobe has finally come to their senses. The new Premiere Pro beta has enabled hardware encoding. That means now you can use all your beefy GPUs to help you cut rendering time, which is really beneficial. It's something that DaVinci Resolve has had over the past years. And it's finally time Adobe caught up. So yeah, everybody knows that rendering with only your CPU at 100% takes a lot of time. I mean, GPUs over the past couple of years have been receiving so much improvement in terms of power and performance. So it will be really beneficial to use that kind of power to help you guys with the rendering time. So what is going on, guys? It's Zarnix here, and today I'm gonna show you guys the new hardware encoding, hardware acceleration for rendering in Premiere Pro. Let's get down to it. So if you guys want to do this too, you guys should head on over to Adobe Creative Cloud, and typically you'll end up here. You'll fall here in all apps. So if you just go to the sidebar here, there's beta apps, and you can just install the current beta for each Adobe software. So in this case, let's do Premiere Pro. So I've installed Premiere Pro beta. Now I'm gonna open this up. Now I haven't tested hardware accelerated rendering on this beta yet. So this is my first time. I'm gonna try it out with you guys for the first time. So right here, I already have an edited gameplay video, which is about 38 minutes long. And before this, my rendering times would typically be about 1.5 times real time. So if I had an hour long video, like a gameplay video, it would take me an hour and 30. At least that's in DaVinci Resolve. I could expect the same here. So let's see if it's any faster than 1.5 times real time. And if you guys are wondering about my system, I have an i7 9th gen CPU along with a GeForce RTX 2070 Super. I don't know if that's gonna create a CPU bottleneck and doesn't really give much of a difference in terms of hardware acceleration, but we'll find out. So I have my timeline here, set in and out points. I'll hit Control M to bring out the exporting. I'm gonna name this file for a bit. I'm pretty sure that this hardware acceleration works for H.264. I'm not sure if it works for any other video formats. I'm going to check render at maximum depth, of course, and oh, there you have it. Hardware encoding utilizes available NVIDIA hardware for quicker encoding. Yes. You know, normally I would only just see software encoding, and I can't even use hardware encoding. Even if you could use hardware encoding, it would be using your iGPU instead of your dedicated GPU, which sucks. I mean, who uses the iGPU anyway? Anyway, moving on, profile high. This is my usual settings. Just maximum render quality. I'll use CBR100 because I usually do that. It may be too much of a bitrate for you guys, but I don't know. I just like having the best quality ever. So without further ado, let's click. Oh my God, I'm so nervous right now. All right, let's do this. Export. Okay, it's less than real time. Is it half the time? Half real time? No, not exactly. But damn, I've never had render speeds that are less than real time. Wow. All right, this is just an estimate time remaining of 22 minutes, but I'm just gonna let this run through, and when it's done, I'll tell you guys how long it actually took. All right, while this is rendering, I'm just gonna show you guys what is going on behind the hood. Let's see if it's actually using that GPU. Oh, okay. Oh, damn. All right, my CPU is still near 90 to 100%. That was normal back then, still going on here. But damn, look at this. My graphics card is 90%. It's almost 100%. It's almost like the CPU. Wow. Oh my God. This power, I've never felt power like this before. I mean, usually it would be 10% or less. Man, I've never seen 90% GPU usage for rendering. Oh my God, I'm gonna love this. Oh, man. Adobe, you have won my heart. You have made me stay. That's right. Yeah, there was a time I was pissed of Adobe not using my GPU as much as I wanted to. So I kind of migrated to DaVinci Resolve for a while, but I didn't get the paid version though. I got I just got the free version. And DaVinci Resolve utilizes the GPU much more better than Adobe Premiere Pro. And in fact, the paid version of DaVinci Resolve, DaVinci Resolve Studio, actually has GPU accelerated rendering, like using NVIDIA encoding, which is what I wanted. So I was almost on the brink of spending $300 more for that feature only, because I've been making a lot of game videos and they're like, dude, they're like hours long, 1 hour. I mean, having to render that is just taking a lot of time. But then this update came out and I think I can save that $300. If Adobe has this, I think I'm sticking with Adobe. Although I'm gonna miss the color grading on DaVinci Resolve and sort of the interface. I just think DaVinci Resolve's interface just looks nicer. And I couldn't just ditch Premiere Pro for DaVinci Resolve. I prefer to have Adobe because I don't just use Premiere Pro. I also use After Effects, Illustrator, Lightroom, Photoshop. I mean, if you ditch Adobe, you ditch all of that. I mean, the only pulling factor for me to use DaVinci Resolve was only that GPU utilization and its color grading, basically. So yeah, but yeah, if you're doing gaming videos, if you're doing hours of long videos, it's good to have this feature without having to pay like $300 for that feature. Pretty sweet. All right, we have finished rendering the video, and according to the stopwatch that I started, it took about 26 minutes and 30 seconds. Well, it's not half the real time, but it's less than real time, which is already good enough for me because I've never had renders under real time, at least for hour long videos. Well, I'm pretty excited to use Adobe Premiere from now on. I'm gonna save myself a lot of time. I'm just gonna be able to do more and more videos, which is really good. And I don't know if you can go faster than this. I mean, without replacing any of your parts. And keep in mind, this was rendered with a constant bit rate of 100 Mbps. So, I mean, you could expect if you're using VBR with a much lower bit rate, I'm pretty sure you're gonna see a lot more shorter render times than what we have today. I mean, I usually do it at CBR 100. Only in certain times I use VBR. So, well, at least CBR 100 is already. Well, it's fast enough. Well, I guess that's it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys learned something new. Again, if you guys want the beta, you just download it from Adobe Creative Cloud Desktop and start using that beefy GPU of yours. Yeah. All right. I think I know what I have to do now. Time to get a better GPU. Yeah. Or maybe have two GPUs, you know? Pretty sweet. Genius. Where's my credit card?